everybody. I'm Ian Mooney, along with sensational Queen Sherry, and welcome to Wrestling Spotlight. Now, your queenship, a lot of questions surrounding the main event at WrestleMania 6. Well, this week, all your questions will be answered. President Jack Tunney is going to join us.
See now, President Jack Tunney.
It's also going to be a great feature matchup. Brutus the Barber Beefcake to meet ravishing Rick Rude. And before we go to our first match, I want to ask you a little bit about what happened this past Friday evening.
I don't want to talk about that, Ian Mooney.
Things didn't exactly turn out the way you had planned.
I don't want to talk about it, Ian Mooney.
Well, Hulk Hogan did retain his...
He's supposed to be such a supreme being, if you will.
Well, the Hulkster did save the Ultimate Warrior, but I think he had other reasons. He wants to be sure the Warrior is healthy for WrestleMania 6. Right now, it's time for our first matchup. Let's go to a match involving Tito Santana.
Welcome to the Miami Arena. I'm Sean Mooney, along with Lord Alfred Hayes, providing color commentary and much more. Alfred, looks like you got a little well done today. Fall asleep on the pool?
No. Fell asleep watching the goals in the pool.
No. Got to get out of the match here. Tito Santana doesn't waste any time before he goes after the Brooklyn Brawler. Misses with an elbow. Tito Santana so quick. He has a brawler up. And down for a body slam and follows it up with a hip toss.
Not only is he incredible, quick, Sean, but he combines that quickness with a lot of power, too. And we saw that very evident in that very, very high hip toss.
A lot of situations, the Brawler's street tactics certainly come in handy. A lot of his moves aren't pretty, but he certainly becomes a formidable opponent in the ring with any superstar. And he'll do whatever it takes to get it done. This is with a clothesline. Tito Santana connects with one of his own, and a drop kick right to the head.
Tremendous drop kick that by Santana. Very, very high indeed, and caught the Brooklyn Brawler flash on the side of the head, and the Brawler, a very, very durable type wrestler. He took that, he went down, but he still seemed to be very much alive.
We got the foot up on the rope there. Manny Davis asked for the break, and Tito Santana, one who plays by the rules, abides. They lock up once again. Tito goes to the wrist lock immediately. And the Brawler goes to something else.
Yes, as you said in the beginning, he's not very pretty, the things he does, but he's very effective indeed. And that can really stop you in your tracks, a shot like that.
This is with a big right. Tito Santana with a flying forearm, hooks a leg. And that's it for the Brooklyn Brawler. Tito Santana, let's make it official. Tito Santana making quick work of the Brooklyn Brawler. Let's get another look at it. Now pretty misses there with that right in the clothesline. Drops the Brawler, a big drop kick. Then Tito Santana off the ropes. Brawler misses with the right. Big flying forearm, and it's adios for the Brooklyn Brawler.
From the World Wrestling Federation magazine, this is Special Report.
Hello, everyone. I'm Lord Alfred Hayes. The question that everybody has been asking is, whose title will be at stake when the World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan goes against the Intercontinental champion, the Ultimate Warrior, in the main event for WrestleMania 6? That intriguing question is about to be resolved by the president of the World Wrestling Federation, Mr. Jack Tunney.
Through the course of the last several weeks, I have deliberated the point as to whose championship should be defended at WrestleMania 6. Both Hulk Hogan, the WWF title holder, and the Ultimate Warrior, the Intercontinental Champion, have adamantly demanded that each one defend their respective title. Therefore, it is my decision that for the first time in World Wrestling Federation history, there will be a match in which champion versus champion, title for title.
So now we know. The official word is, it will be champion versus champion and title for title when the Ultimate Warrior clashes with the incomparable Hulk Hogan in the main event for WrestleMania 6. Here are both men with their pointed comments.
You know something, Hulkamaniacs? Champion versus champion is one thing. The Ultimate Warrior versus Hulk Hogan is another. But title for title is the only way WrestleMania 6 could go down. Jack Tunney, you're a smart man, dude. You realize that when the two strongest forces in the WWF collide, one will probably be wiped out. You know, Warrior, don't get me wrong, brother. What went down last Friday night just wasn't an act of kindness, dude. When I saw the earthquake get ready to soar, when I saw that there may be a chance that you'd be wiped out and splattered all over the mat, that's why I came down, brother. I'm going to watch your back from now until WrestleMania 6. I don't want a hair on your head. I don't want a scratch or a mark on your body, Warrior. Because when you get in WrestleMania 6 and Hulkamania wipes you out, we don't want any excuses, dude. You know, I've thought about this thing over and over again. I've thought about the Sky Dome. I've thought about the intensity of all my Hulkamaniacs on my back, Jack. Everybody knows this is where the Hulkster's power lies, dude. And as I lock up with you, Ultimate Warrior, in my mind, I can feel the snap, crackle, and pop of your wrists and your fingertips as you bend at the power of the strongest arms in the world. And then, as I reach down and cinch up with a bear hug, Ultimate Warrior, I can feel the life and breath of your darkness, of all your gods that you talk about being squeezed out of your body. And as the intensity level blows the walls off the place, the roof of the Sky Dome will open up, Ultimate Warrior. And as Hulkamania is running wild with the whole world watching, brother, your gods as witnesses and mine will be up there. That's where I'll strike you down, Ultimate Warrior, in the Sky Dome, with the heavens, with the whole world watching. And what are you gonna do when the largest arms in the world and the Hulkster destroys you? Have we the Warrior ever gone into battle unprepared? When that is what we only live for? To feel the combat and the rage and the challengers that come before us? Earthquake was nothing but another challenger. A man filled with many great strengths. To make the power that I command even stronger to deal with Hulk Hogan, I need not you to watch my back. The warriors that ride with me will make the sacrifice. The ones that fall, the others that stay, will show no pity to those that were not strong enough to survive. Hulk Hogan, in my world, a place where you have come close to, but I've never been. Belts, normal representations of champions do not walk with the Ultimate Warrior. I walk where you can no longer breathe, Hulk Hogan. I walk where the pain I shall receive only makes me stronger. You, Hulk Hogan, have a question. I, Hulk Hogan, have the answer to that question. I do not need to know what is the most awesome force
I, Hulk Hogan. Am the only force.
I would like to say we are being entertained here in Fort Myers, but this is far from entertainment. Hello, everyone. I'm Sean Mooney along with Lord Alfred Hayes. And we are about to see a tag team encounter, and it is underway already. The Bolsheviks going right after their opponents, Al Burke and Terry Bronson. Barely got their coats off, Alfred.
Really, they're trying to make short work of this combination of Burke and Bronson. And these Russians are very hefty, big fellows. And they really are charged up for this particular encounter. And that, of course, is Bronson on the end of the rock.
Process of elimination. He ended up the first man in the ring for his tag team. And Nikolai Volkov continues the punishment. As for the boot from Boris Zhukov, he gets about a size 14.
He certainly does. Boris responded to that offer from his partner Nikolai.
Well, Alfred, you know the Russian Bolsheviks as of late have been on a tear. And earlier we had a chance to get a few comments from them. Let's hear from Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov.
Як це виживаєте, товариші? Я поздравляю все совєтський народ.
At the top of team of the world, the Bolsheviks are ready. We are training hard. We want to represent our country, the Soviet Union, and WrestleMania 6. We are ready for anyone, any tag team who dare to take us on.
Alfred, which one of the Russian Bolsheviks there was speaking Russian?
Well, the first to speak was Nikolai Volkov, and that was Russian, I'm almost sure. Mm-hmm. And the second one, of course, was Boris Zhukov, his partner. What he was speaking, which language, I really don't know. I didn't understand a word.
That's a good thing that they can translate their actions into the ring. Double wing suplex there, double arm, and Bronson still taking the brunt.
I think you were right the first time, a double wing, because Bronson absolutely flew through the air there.
Yes, he did. Bouncing hard, and in comes Zhukov. Clothesline from behind there. And the Russian Bolsheviks make quick work of Al Burke and Terry Bronson.
A very impressive victory there by the Bolsheviks. Boris Zhukov and Nikolai Volkov, a great tag team.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sean Mooney. The World Wrestling Federation is set to rock the Capitol Center once again. It happens this Sunday night. And you will see Jake the Snake Roberts and the Ultimate Warrior in the main event, taking on Akeem and the Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase. Now, that duo is standing by with some last-minute comments. But first, let's run down the rest of the card. Bret the Hitman Hart, he faces Greg the Hammer Valentine. Rugged Ronnie Garvin taking on the Earthquake, Jimmy Hart at ringside for that battle. In a return bout, the Colossal Connection, Andre the Giant and Haku, they meet Axe and Smash of Demolition. And listen to this. Dusty Rhodes will be at the Capitol Center, accompanied by Sapphire, when he meets the Macho King Randy Savage. Also, sensational Queen Sherry will be at ringside. And in the main event, the special referee is none other than the Big Boss Man. And right now, Akeem and the Million Dollar Man are standing by with more on this main event.
Jake, you think you got it all figured out, right? You've got it all together. You've stolen the million-dollar belt. Yeah, you got to me a little bit. Now you've hired the Ultimate Warrior. Oh, yeah. You got somebody in your corner you think you can depend on. Well, let me tell you something. The Warrior's got a lot on his mind lately. You know what I mean, Jake? And then the Big Boss Man. You got Tony in your hip pocket. And the Boss Man, you think you can really trust the Boss Man? Well, I don't know. He doesn't have a price. He can't be bought. How do you know you can trust him? Well, I know when I lay this in this man's hand, I can trust him to get the job done. And he will get the job done. And you, Jake the Snake Roberts, will be mine once and for all.
Akeem and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, set for this tag team match, and so is the special referee. Let's hear from the Big Boss Man.
Jack Tunney, you come to the Big Boss Man. You say, we got a match signed between four men. Four men that are out of control, who have no respect for the law and the World Wrestling Federation. So we need a man, a special man, a special referee that can handle every man in the ring at one time. Well, Tony, you're looking at the man who can put everybody back in line where they belong. So Virgil and Slick, if you get in my way, I'm going to put you away.
Ah. He will indeed be the long arm of the law in the ring this Sunday night at the Capitol Center. Make sure you're there. Right now, though, it's time to feel the power of the WWF.
Mundo Entertainment System presents. From Tequila, Mexico, Tito Santana. This Latin lover of wrestling shows no regard for his opponents. And when Tito delivers a red-hot flying forearm to his enemigo, he's quickly sent south of the border.
Look at that, McMahon. That is gross.
Well, you know, what do you want? They're gross. Admittedly, they're gross, all right? But they're also extremely popular in the World Wrestling Federation. One of the most popular tag teams in a long, long time. Clothesline.
That's because all you do is extol the virtues of them, and people believe you.
Wait a minute. What do you mean extolling the virtues of them?
And people
you
believe
said they were
you.
Gross. I agreed with you. Is that extolling someone's virtue?
They're what they are.
That's all they are. The Bushwhackers.
Look at fighting. Fighting.
See, you
week after
how
week.
Could you see that they were fighting?
Week after week, they bite people and nothing's
Luke
done
can't
to
fight him. You're, that's a lie. Luke can't bite. He has no teeth. He can gum you, but he can't bite you.
One.
Nope, that's not going to do it. Tag is made. Here comes Butch. Ooh, wow. Wide open here. Butch and Luke, little double teaming going on.
Wow, face first into that buckle.
And Butch now. Back body. Ooh, wow. Nicely executed.
I don't believe it. A wrestling move.
Hey, these guys know what they're doing. You can tell.
You know, I'll never cease to be amazed week after week.
Really?
Who would have thought these guys knew a wrestling move?
They can open a can of sardines faster than you can wink, I can tell you that.
Now look at no ref, no count by Danny Davis.
Oh, a battering ram! And Butch and Luke looking pretty good in there at the moment. What's going to happen now? Uh-oh. Ooh, down to the... Ooh.
Why isn't Davis counting?
Well, let me see. You think he's mesmer? He is counting.
Yeah,
he's
now.
Counting the three.
What an illegal rear end was.
Really?
Totally.
Here we go, winner.
Luke and Butch.
I mean, Danny Davis stood back and let them do illegal double teaming the last three or four moves in the ring and then counts three.
I didn't see it that way. You know, I mean, if you're an official. Hello. If you're an official, I mean, you know, the stench of those sardines really has to take its toll on you.
Time is quickly running out. If you plan to see it all this Sunday evening at the Capitol Center, do not waste another moment. Get down to the box office and secure your seats. In the main event, Akeem and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, taking on Jake the Snake Roberts and the Ultimate Warrior. The referee in the ring is none other than the Big Boss Man. Also, the Macho King, Randy Savage. He goes head-to-head with Dusty Rhodes.
Yeah, let me tell you about it. I was thinking all about it. The brothers on the street are talking about it. Everybody around the world seen it live. When one Queen Sherry started ridiculing the American dream, the common folk, if you will. I am folk, yes, sir. And Macho Man, the king, if you will, Randy Savage, said, I want Dusty Rhodes, the legendary American dream. Well, you got all of it you can stand, baby. Nobody runs down my people, my common folk, if you will, in public. Much less my lady Safi. Come in here, darling.
Oh, yeah! Randy King, we got something for you, too!
Ooh, and I'm gonna put it on you like she rode you.
There may be as much action outside of the ring when Dusty Rhodes meets the Macho King Randy Savage. Remember, Sapphire and Sensational Queen Sherry will be at ringside. Greg the Hammer Valentine, he faces Bret the Hitman Hart. Let's hear from the Hitman.
You know something? Greg the Hammer Valentine is one wrestler that you do not take lightly. And the Hitman is looking at the Hammer with a very, very serious eye. Because I've seen too many wrestlers carried back to the dressing room, crippled. Put out of wrestling business for good. All because they made the mistake of taking Greg the Hammer Valentine too lightly. Well, the Hitman, the excellence of execution, is going to go in the ring mentally, physically prepared. And Hammer, I know you got a lot of tricks up your sleeve. But the Hitman's got a lot of tricks up his sleeve too. So when you step in the ring, you better know one thing, that the Hitman is going to take you to the distance.
Bret the Hitman Hart, he faces Greg the Hammer Valentine. It all happens this Sunday evening, and that is just part of the lineup of World Wrestling Federation action you can be a part of this Sunday night, beginning at 7:30 p.m. at the Capitol Center.
Now, Ravaging Rick Rude.
One of the top members of the Heenan family.
Now. And you wonder whether or not Mr. Rude will be participating in WrestleMania 6. And if so, with whom?
Cut the music.
Thumbs down. Jesse, look at the fink, Jess. Look at the fink in the back.
Why do I want to look at him when I can look at her?
Boy, that's a good question. Whoa, yeah! On his way to the ring!
The Barber Beefcake!
The Barber set the lock up against Ravishing Rick Rude. And the ladies in the audience now have someone to really cheer for.
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't think Beefcake's going to have that many fans for him here.
Why is that?
Because imagine if he beat Ravishing Rick Rude and cut Rude's beautiful hair.
Yeah?
I mean, that wouldn't make Rude ravishing anymore, would it?
That's a good point. Certainly not as ravishing. But the ladies, I believe, are a little more fond of Beefcake than they are of Mr. Rude. Take a look at those tights, would you? A little kiss. A little scratch. I guess.
Trying to psych out Rick Rude. Can you imagine that?
Ask you words of advice from the brain.
I mean, does Beefcake really believe he can psych out a former Intercontinental Champion like that?
Why not?
Why not?
Yeah. Lock it up, Beefcake and Rude. What a matchup this is. Both men, standoff. They're going to try it again. And Rude now. Nope. Neither individual able to gain an advantage.
Absolutely not. That looks like a toss-up. Flip the coin.
Oh, a little display, if you would, of biceps. And now... Well, judging from the cheer, we're having a pose down here.
Yeah, look at who the idiots are judging. What does Miami know about muscle?
They must know a lot. Locking up here. Test of strength. Standing by, Mr. Perfect.
Oh, Beefcake, I'm keeping a close eye on you. Every move you make for what you did to the genius at the Royal Rumble. I promise you this, Beefcake. It will never, ever happen again.
And again, these two so evenly
take
matched.
Take your time.
Don't rush
anything.
You hear the brain outside with the instructions. Let's see if Rude follows up.
Ooh, no, did you see that?
Brilliant on the part of Ravishing Rick Rude.
Rude with the advantage.
Beefcake went for a cheap shot. The ref hooked him. Rude saw the opening and took advantage.
And he's still taking advantage. Ravishing Rick Rude throwing the forearms into the side of the head of Brutus the Barber. Continuing his attack. Rude being admonished by the official. Oh, yeah! Turnabout fair play! Brutus the Barber Beefcake now winding up. Hard right hand!
Well, Bobby Heenan don't think turnabout's fair play.
And Brutus again! Brutus, wait a minute. Mr. Perfect coming in! Perfect! Hammering on Brutus Beefcake!
And I guess that's what Brutus is going to look
at
forward
Jesus
to.
In there. Those hard soul shoes. Three individuals.
That's what he gets for cutting a genius's hair. I'll bet you Beefcake will think twice now about giving anybody a haircut.
Beefcake literally kicked out of the ring by Mr. Perfect Genius and Ravishing Rick Rude. But right now, Beefcake has the scissors. Oh, he almost got Perfect.
Yeah, but almost don't count. He's a little bit too late.
Result of a disqualification.
Well, as you can see, the barber's shears are sharper than ever, and Mr. Perfect and Rick Rude did not want to hang around to find out.
Well, Todd, I don't know why anyone would let Brutus Beefcake carry a big pair of scissors about this long, wanting to cut Mr. Perfect's gorgeously blonde hair, and even trying to get after Ravishing Rick Rude, the winner of the Jesse the Body Award. See, now Tunney allows such a thing to go on.
What about the other announcement we heard from President Jack Tunney that it's going to be a title versus title in the main event at WrestleMania 6?
Title versus title?
Yes, Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior, the Intercontinental Championship versus the World Wrestling Federation
Championship. You're not going to sit there and tell me that I got to pick one of them that I like, because I don't like either one of them.
Well, didn't say you had to like them.
Well,
but
I don't.
If you were to choose, who is
I don't want to choose. I choose a macho king.
Well, how about choosing Brother Love right now? He's standing by with Akeem and the Doctor Style Slick.
Woo! Stay it with your hand.
Brother Love hit with a great big pie right in the kisser. Hello? Are you nodding up? You got too much sun left,
man.
What? I like to listen to Brother Love. Would you just keep quiet? What a joke. You think you could do that just once?
This is the man I put my confidence and my trust in, brother.
Yes, indeed. And he is a real man.
A real brother. 457 pounds from the deep, darkest part of Africa, Daddy. You understand exactly what I'm saying. Now, Big Boss Man, you such a tough guy. With a 130-pound manager. But I want to make an official challenge right here and now. I want to see Flat Top. Do you have the guts to step in the ring with a man that's bigger, badder, and better than you could ever dream of being?
Yes, yes, indeed. Of course, you know, we all have money. And speaking of money, well, what a surprise! Welcome, Brother Million Dollar Man. Welcome. What are you doing out here?
You know, Brother Love, Jake the Snake is just exactly what his name implies. A snake in the grass who stole something that didn't belong to him. $1 million worth of my property. And I paid a great deal of money to have that property recovered. But Boss Man, you were too stupid to take the money. And that makes you an accessory to the crime. But Brother Love, there are those who will take the money, who will get the job done, and who will deliver the goods. Slickster, I promise you that there will be a great deal of added incentive given to Brother Akeem if he takes the Boss Man out.
See the look on the Slickster's face? They're making some kind of deal.
Like I've always said, everybody's got a price for the $1 million man.
My, my.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, coast to coast and border to border, WrestleMania 6, Sky Dome, Toronto, Canada, Sunday, April the 1st, 4 p.m. Eastern start. And oh, what an afternoon and evening of World Wrestling Federation action it is going to be. By the way, if you do want to join us live and in person, there is a telephone number you can call. That number, 416-872-1111. Join us for the big one in Toronto on a live and in-person basis. What a tremendous card. Just added, Earthquake, to meet Hercules, Earthquake at 469 pounds to deal with the strength of the mighty Hercules. Akeem, the African Dream. Speaking of big man, Akeem will be facing this man. He is the Big Boss Man.
Slick, you made an error in judgment of character, didn't you, boy? You found out I couldn't be bought, and I'm not a thief. So bring your big brother, Akeem, down to WrestleMania 6. He's going to find out there's going to be no chance for parole, no chance for suspended sentence, nothing but hard times.
That meeting to take place in the biggest wrestling spectacular ever. Plus, Brutus the Barber Beefcake to meet Mr. Perfect. Let's go back to the Royal Rumble and take a look at action in progress between Beefcake and the Genius. But look for the intervention on the part of Mr. Perfect.
There's Mr. Perfect.
Yeah, it takes two, doesn't it? He's still down. He is trying to get up.
Mr. Perfect coming to the aid of the Genius.
The bell is sounded. The referee is up. And Mr. Perfect has a chair.
Uh-oh. Is Brutus going to pay? Is Brutus going to pay?
Oh, no.
Oh.
Jesse, that could break a rib. Some more referees in now. The referee.
Oh, he got him again.
No.
On the heels of that incident, we received these comments from Brutus Beefcake.
Mr. Perfect, when you jumped on me at Brutus's barbershop, do you really think you're going to get away with a shave without a haircut for just two bits? Well, you know, I got a reputation. Sometimes I just kind of go crazy, like maybe in WrestleMania 6 when I ruined your perfect reputation.
Psychologically, Brutus the Barber Beefcake is ready for his meeting with Mr. Perfect. Jake the Snake Roberts will be facing the $1 million man, Ted DiBiase. At stake, the $1 million belt. With that, let's hear from the $1 million man.
WrestleMania 6, Jake the Snake, now it's my turn for revenge. And for the first time in the history of the World Wrestling Federation, a title match for a belt worth $1 million. My $1 million belt. And though it disgusts me that I got to put my belt on the line to get it back, it doesn't matter. I'll do anything I have to do. And remember this, Jake, he who laughs last, laughs best.
After this one is over and done with, will the $1 million man possess the $1 million belt? And don't forget the ultimate challenge, champion versus champion, title for title, as Hulk Hogan meets the Ultimate Warrior. Ladies and gentlemen, again, for you to join us live and in person, here's the telephone number you could call to order by phone, 416-872-1111. And by the way, you can experience WrestleMania 6. TCA, the official travel agency of WrestleMania, offers you exclusive 2- and 3-night packages to experience WrestleMania live and in person. Call 800-622-0305. Hotel accommodations available at Skydome Hotel and the Royal York Hotel. Packages include priority seating, hotel accommodations, and a VIP reception. Again, the date is Sunday, April the 1st, 4 p.m. Eastern Time, Skydome in Toronto, Canada. Be part of WrestleMania at Skydome. With your WrestleMania report, I'm Jim.
For our feature matchup, and he is carrying arrogance with him. More ways than one.
More ways than one.
Yeah.
kind of shiny, so to speak, to the model Rick Bartel.
Have you had a chance to smell arrogance yet?
No, I haven't.
Get ready.
I got a chip. I smelled Brother Love, though, a number of times.
Oh, oh.
Boy, he's spraying everything.
Matchup. The model Rick Martel, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, and Sapphire, who's still in the ring area. The model wants her out of the ring.
Well, she better get out of there.
She's not intimidated at all.
Doesn't she know that the music has stopped, Tony?
Apparently it's not. As we take a look at the...
She's still dancing around in there. Martel getting a little upset here. Come on, referee, do your job. Get her out of there and get the match going.
Martel wants to get a hold of Sapphire. And Dusty.
Casting some aspersions.
Showing the world what he thinks of the model, Rick Martel. Martel still going after Sapphire.
Who's still in there?
Who's still in there?
There she goes.
Oh,
from behind.
Now it's the model taking the advantage of the situation, feeling good about it also with Dusty. No, Dusty with a good reversal land. Good cartwheel. I wouldn't turn my back on Dusty Rhodes.
Right between the eyes, and now it's all dream time.
Oh, the model rolls right outside. The best place for him right now, Dusty's on a roll right here.
Well, that's smart thinking on the part of Rick Martel, the model. Anytime you're in deep trouble, you get out there, try to break the momentum of your opponent, and he did that quite nicely.
The model, with that cartwheel and a big smile on his face, it's not on his face right now, but earlier on we had a chance to talk to him, and he was smiling then. Let's listen to this.
Take a look at me. A masterpiece in motion, a walking work of art. Yes, I've got it all. Looks, physique, ability. And I know I'm going to have the sweet smell of victory after this mess is over. Mm.
I'm sure glad something's going to smell sweet.
Well, the smell of arrogance, too.
Watch out, Dusty caught the foot.
Well, let's be realistic now, Tony. You got to admit that the model has the equipment and the ability to do it, too.
Well, there's no question of that.
Whether he could do it against this guy or not remains to be seen, but he's got a lot going for himself.
Dusty is staying right at him. The model goes right to the forehead and with a rake to the eyes, gets the advantage. Dusty staggers down to one knee. The model trying to put something together here. Nicely done again. Sapphire doesn't like it at all. She's complaining to the referee. Right to the midsection.
Going to work on the midsection. That could be the weak spot of the Dream.
Never know. Double axe handle blows. The Dream is down, and Martel right after him again. He's going to work on the midsection again, and you're right. He's staying on one part now, the midsection of Dusty Rhodes. Dusty's getting back up, though. He was waiting on him, Grilla.
Certainly was. Caught him in midair, right downstairs in the breadbasket. And another one of those elbows right between the eyes.
Staggered the model to the corner. Dusty laying in the chops. And the fans right with him. Oh, the referee gets shoved down. No, the model's got arrogance.
Look out.
Well, right in the eyes.
Right in the eyes is right.
Oh, my goodness.
He's blinded.
And that arrogance went right in the eyes. And then right in the eyes of Dusty, and now Sapphire's backed up.
He got a good shot of that stuff, too. You know what it's like, Tony. You get a little bit on your hand, and you just touch her, I imagine.
That's right.
Getting shot with it, but yeah. The Dream is back on his feet.
And comes to the aid of Sapphire.
He got his hand raised.
Yes. He's still spraying the ring arrow.
This is it. It all comes down to this Sunday evening, beginning at 7:30 p.m. at the Capitol Center. World Wrestling Federation action at its finest. Axe and Smash of Demolition in a return encounter. They'll meet the Colossal Connection, Andre the Giant and Haku.
You know, I could sing the praises all day about my Colossal Connection. And Demolition, nobody knows better than you how tough the Colossal Connection is.
And you want to fight a tough foe we got? You fight me. Come in that ring and fight like a man, because you don't look like a man to us anymore.
What can I say? The cement truck is right in front of us, Bobby. Hit it. The family are staying. The Andre the Giant will give it.
Colossal Connection out to prove they are the superior tag team and that they truly deserve to wear the belts. We will see about that this Sunday night. The Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and Akeem facing Jake the Snake Roberts and the Ultimate Warrior.
It's going to be a cold day for you, DiBiase. A cold, hard day. But I'll tell you something. Don't blame the boss man. Don't blame Virgil. Don't blame the WWF for giving us the special referee. Blame yourself. Don't blame me for picking him. You picked the king. Don't blame anybody but yourself. You're responsible for everything that happens to Ted DiBiase.
Nobody can assume the responsibility for the delivery of a creature and structure such as myself. No man can ride the lowest lows like you, Jake the Snake Roberts, until he has experienced the highest highs. With the warriors on my back and the poison from the snake, we will prevail.
The Ultimate Warrior and Jake the Snake Roberts, ready for the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase and Akeem. But will they be ready for the special referee, the Big Boss Man? It all happens this Sunday night, February 25th, at the Capitol Center. Also, Tugboat Thomas, he drops anchor for singles competition. Rugged Ronnie Garvin taking on the Natural Disaster Earthquake. Greg the Hammer Valentine, he faces Bret the Hitman Hart in a return bout, the Colossal Connection. They'll take on Axe and Smash of Demolition. Dusty Rhodes set to go one-on-one with the Macho King Randy Savage. Both Sapphire and Sensational Queen Sherry at ringside. And the Big Boss Man is the referee when Akeem and the Million Dollar Man face Jake the Snake Roberts and the Ultimate Warrior this Sunday night at the Capitol Center. What great action we saw here on Wrestling Spotlight this week. We also learned a lot more about WrestleMania 6. What about this matchup between Brutus the Barber Beefcake and Mr. Perfect?
I think this is going to be the perfect opportunity, Ian Mooney, for Mr. Perfect to send that Beefcake right back where he came from.
You can almost hear this collision happening. Akeem meeting his former tag team partner, the Big Boss Man. Now that is going to be some match.
Well, if I'm a betting woman, then I'm going to put my money on Akeem and the Slickster due to the fact that the Big Boss Man is nothing but a... He's no good.
We'll leave it at that.
Yes.
Hercules will collide with the Earthquake, and also we didn't hear this earlier, but we have learned that Jake the Snake Roberts will battle the Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase. Now that's all part of WrestleMania 6. Next week, right here on Wrestling Spotlight, a great matchup. Haku will take on Smash of Demolition. Now before we sign off here, I know there's something different about you. You got your crown back.
Oh, yes. That is a coincidence that you noticed something like that, Ian. Would you like to know where I found it?
Well, sure.
I found it in your office.
You didn't find it in the closet.
Oh, sure, yes, I did. You know exactly where I found it. And you know what? That wasn't the only thing that I found in your closet,
Ian. What are you talking about?
I found this. Real cute color for you, Ian.
I've never found these.
I bet that looks real good.
Do you think for one instant that these things have anything to do with me? I don't know where you found them.
Due to the fact that I think you wear a size 11 shoe, and I found a couple of those in your closet, too.
You don't know how tough they are to find.
Yeah, that's right. Admit it.
For Sensational Queen Sarah and Ian Mooney, we'll see you next week on Wrestling Spotlight.
No, that's yours.